Hello, my name is Chris, and this is Writing Delight.
Today I have the Procyon from Platinum here for you. I would like to thank the company Aratrom, who provided me with this fountain pen for testing and subsequent review. As always though, there was no influence. These are all my opinions. The Procyon comes in 5 different color versions. One of them is this citron yellow version. The fountain pen has a pretty simple shape with a flattened finial and barrel end. A simple clip and the cap in silver loosen up the look. The cap is screwed on. Under the cap you will find the plain nib and a plastic grip section. The thread, which is quite long, is made of metal. The Platinum Procyon is a cartridge fountain pen. By the way, the base of the barrel is above the thread for the cap. A few details. First, between the clip and the end of the cap, we have the Procyon lettering printed in silver. On the back of the cap, Platinum, made in Japan, is printed. The nib is, as already mentioned, very plain. Only the Platinum logo and the nib strings is engraved here. But the special thing about this fountain pen is on the back of the nib, the feet. Because here you can see a small channel that protrudes far into the nib area. Here, once in a close-up with the usual fountain pen in comparison. This channel moves the filling opening further forward. If you draw the fountain pen with a converter directly over the nib, the ink is sucked up through this opening. The fact that this opening is moved further forward than the Platinum Procyon means that the ink can be sucked up deeper in the ink bottle. This is a detail that is not often important, but if the ink in an inkwell is nearing the end, you can still suck up a little more ink than normally. By the way, if you want to fill the fountain pen with an ink cartridge, you have to take the Platinum cartridges here. These are inserted with a thick end facing forward. There's also a middle ball there. The thin end does not work. The fountain pen still fits reasonably in the hand, even with larger hands. But it is more comfortable for me with the cap posted. In the grip area, the plastic part is relatively small. With larger fingers, you usually rest on the thread, but that is not sharp-edged or pressing. Let's move on to the writing test. The Platinum Procyon writes pleasantly with a small feedback. The nib is relatively stiff, but slight line variance can be produced. I filled the pen with a J. Herbin Rouge Grenat ink. Let's have a look at the size of this fountain pen. By the way, you can find the other data in the description as always. Here now in a comparison with the Diplomat Aero, a Visconti Homo Sapiens, a Pelikan M800 Blue Blue, Alami Zafari, and a Pelican P205. When closed, the Procyon is in the midfield. When open and with the cap posted, it gets a little smaller in comparison. Without the cap, it is the same length as a P205. And with the cap posted, it becomes a bit longer again. Overall, this is a good usable pen. Of course, the idea of moving the filling port to the front makes for a better use of the ink from the inkwell. At least, if you use a converter and draw it up over the nib. With a cartridge, this has no further use. Overall though, I like the solution, even if it's not visually the prettiest option you could possibly choose. What bothers me a bit though is the grip area of the fountain pen. The actual plastic grip area is relatively short. There will be some who feel like they are resting their fingers on the quite long thread with it. Fortunately, this is not unpleasantly designed, but I'd find it not optimal. However, it does not disturb. The simple clip is a pity. A spring-loaded clip could surely be in its price segment, I think. It would be good for the fountain pen. Otherwise, it's a well thought out and crafted fountain pen that is fun to use. The available colors are also rather bright and cheerful. It's a light fountain pen with a metal barrel and a plastic grip section. Of course, as usual with Platinum, it only accepts Platinum cartridges or converters. But there's also a converter to the standard international connector. This should also work here. As with most Platinum fountain pens, we also have a modern nib here. A slim body, straight, sloping shoulders, and with almost no ornamentation. As usual with Platinum, however, the nib writes excellently. The nib in the Procyon is significantly larger and longer than the nib in the Preppy. By the way, if you want to, you could screw in the nib from a C776 here. All in all though, it's a fountain pen that's good to use and actually stands out in all color versions. It's in the Platinum series of fountain pens in the price range between the Preppy, respectively the Profound, and the 3776. As we are looking at a price of around 60 euros here. How do you like the fountain pen? Would it be something for you? Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the review. Feel free to give me a subscription and a like. That would help this channel and me a lot. Among others, more fountain pen reviews are coming soon. For example, from Online, Schaeffer, and Waldmann. See you next time.